I'm live here on Fort Myers Beach. A lot of you recognize this intersection. It's right near Times Square, and this is where you come off the Matanzas Pass Bridge, and you would turn right to get to Times Square for the parking and for the beach. And the lights are, traffic lights are still out here, but there are signs of recovery. They've got We Are Open signs on that restaurant behind me. There's the souvenir shop, two different ice cream shops here. So certainly things are moving forward. But, you know, part of recovery is facing the mental challenges that come along with that. NBC2 First Alert meteorologist Jason Dunning recently sat down with two Barrier Island residents as well as a licensed counselor and is asking the question that so many of us have on our minds. When will it get better?
Has it gotten better at all with each month?
At times you'll think it is, but I think now with hurricane season and global warming, it's building back up again.
And you have all these triggers now, right, as we get into a new hurricane season. I mean, David, in terms of a timeline for healing from something like this, how long does it normally take?
You know, Jason, everyone is different and everyone's brain chemistry is different. You know, PTSD does not heal over time. And that statement, time heals everything, is about as incorrect of a statement that we could ever be repeating. Time heals nothing. Time plus work heals, but time by itself won't heal a thing. And that's where we have people like hurricane survivors that 20 years down the road, if they've never done any work, the falling of a palm frond will snap them into an experience, a slamming of a car door, right? Or a torrential rain that may only be lasting 20 minutes can send them into a tizzy in 20 years, Jason. And both of you can probably pretty much agree that this could happen if we don't do the work. You know, and a lot of us shy away from the work because some of the work means going back into those feelings, emotions, and experiences.
Tracy, Misty, is there anything that you've done that's helped with that healing process?
I am feeling better only because I have my house back. And I'm very lucky because I work for a construction company. And if I didn't, I don't know what I would have done. I didn't get any insurance money. I feel grateful because I love my house now. So I think I have a different kind of perspective on it because I still have all the anxiety. June 1st, I went and got fans. My hurricane kit is crazy now because I really didn't prepare before. I didn't know. So after the hurricane, I mean, I was living with a coworker. My kids were living with friends. And I was so grateful at the time, but I was still so angry because I didn't have my bed, you know. But I did see a therapist after because I didn't know how to deal with all the feelings of being grateful yet being angry.
I can honestly say I haven't. I mean, I don't know where to start. Having lost everything and jobs and being unemployed and not receiving insurance, it's just been overwhelming. And I have a hard time focusing, you know, dealing with one thing or the other. Tried to get away a little and do some things like that, but it's always in the back of your mind. And I think people don't realize, but I'm also helping my mom because she's displaced now and our businesses, and we have two Great Danes and a Frenchie and all that. I need to get into therapy, and I know that. I just feel like now, without income, without all kinds of things, it's a process, and it's going very slowly, too slowly.
Where do you start?
Well, you know, you mentioned therapy, and at this stage, without seeing any kind of improvement for this long, I would say that's step number one. You know, I really believe that. Now, therapy is not scary, okay? I want to tell you this right off the top, okay? But it can feel scary when we're being this vulnerable and we're saying, I have all of these things for the past 10 months. I feel scattered. I don't feel grounded. Am I pretty correct, right? Okay. So then what we do is we would say, let's choose one positive, distractive hobby or activity a day. Just one. Now, the next thing I'm going to say, which is very powerful, and it's a therapeutic tool that a lot of people will shy away from for quite a while, is writing the PTSD story. And what we do it for is something called desensitization. So when you write the story over and over of everything that happened, right, and this is hard work, mm-hmm. but eventually as you write it, you start to say, well, no wonder I'm feeling these things. Like, it brings logic into our emotions. Right, so when we write down this happened, we can say anyone would feel depressed, anxious, PTSD, lost, unfocused, depressed, right? Like when you see it in writing, what you went through, mm-hmm. believe it or not, it's an incredible healing experience. It's scary.
But just talking about it makes my heart beat really.
I bet it does. I bet it does. So if I was working with you, what I would say is write one or two paragraphs a day and stop. You know, so I remember this day, there was a warning done, and I thought we had everything together. I thought we had enough canned food and blah, 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 right? And maybe that's all you write for that day. And then the next day you write another section and another section. And eventually you get to the point where the full story is written out. And then you can say, whew,